There we go. You're lying.
Get in there with you. Come on, everybody. He's
gonna
turn it on. Yeah,
he's
gonna turn it on. Come on, get in there and get
though. All right, Leo. Happy graduation.
Happy graduation, Leo. Get in there.
I know she's like
1, 2, 3. Woo, 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 woo for Leo.
Yeah.
Special guests and congratulations, class of 2022. Give it up again. As I invite Holy Spirit and connection into this space with us, I invite us all to take a deep cleansing breath in. Go ahead, take a deep breath. An audible breath out. I want to hear it. Beautiful. You made it. Holy Spirit, in your name, I welcome our highest good and full being of each person here. With it, let the full measure of love, community, peace, and compassion fill our hearts as we celebrate our graduating class. I welcome our ancestors, our family, far and wide, biological and chosen, those who could be here and those who could not. I pray that we'd be filled with gratitude for their love, support, and sacrifices. We ask you to bless our graduates as we are reminded of all those who have helped them get to this very moment. Every attentive professor, supportive staff, loving friend, and patient family member, it would not be without them that they could be here. Pastoral Counselor Alice DePerry writes, At the heart of human existence and of all creation, there is a profound interconnectedness and intricate interdependence. We are created dependent and interrelated. The self as we know it individually is negotiated within the context of community. We need to remember that we did not create ourselves, that we owe what we are to the communities that formed us. Further, author and activist Adrienne Marie Brown writes, in a fractal conception, I am a cell-sized unit of the human organism, and I have to use my life to leverage a shift in the system by how I am, as much as the things I do. This means actually being in my life, and it means bringing my values into my daily decision-making. Lord, I pray that you have blessed our graduates' time at Warren Wilson College, having learned the ability to speak from a place of authenticity and alignment. It is how they will go on to build a more authentic and more aligned society. God, I thank you for the tenacity, brilliance, and curiosity of this year's graduating class. They have had a college experience unlike any other, and are in prime position to lead their communities, this world, in forging new paths for work, for academics, and for community engagement. Bless their ability to lean into conflict, to welcome it as opportunity for growth, for connection, and for renewal. Finally, Lord, please send them wisdom to care for those around them, the courage to have hard conversations, and the peace to continually choose their highest self.
Welcome to the Warren Wilson College graduating class of 2022. Here we are, together at last. Welcome to you graduates and your families and your friends and Warren Wilson faculty, staff, students, board members, and honored guests. Joining me up on the platform today are Lash Zimp, Chair of the Board of Trustees, Pinky Stegall, Chair of our Alumni Board, and members of the President's Cabinet, Provost Dr. J. Roberts, and also Vice President for Administration and Finance and Chief Financial Officer Belinda Burke. I am very grateful for all of their dedication and hard work. I am so excited to greet you on this special day. Today, we celebrate 156 students receiving degrees. To the class of 2022, how rewarding it has been to see you change and grow over these last 4 years, half of which were spent in a global pandemic. None of us saw that coming when you arrived here. I have gotten to know you in our conversations about the issues and activities you engage with on campus and in the wider world, and in email exchanges, SGA, the President's Group I convened this spring, and on work day. I have admired your courage to speak up and stand up, your resilience, your passion, and your hard work. At commencement, presidents always acknowledge the focused work and commitment that led to this glorious moment. But you, my friends, you truly walked through the fire before you got to this moment. In a global pandemic, the likes of which have not been seen since 1918, you have learned online, have adapted to COVID protocols at home, at work, and in the classroom, and have experienced the many losses that this pandemic has wrought. And you have been resilient and determined to keep going and finish your college degree. You will remember this time for the rest of your lives, inextricably tied to your college experience. Be proud of that. It has not been easy, but you have triumphed in your arrival at this moment of completion. It's difficult to see an era as a historic moment when you are living in it. The past several years here have been as tumultuous as what the rest of the country has been experiencing. You've stepped up as students and as activists who seek to change the world during all of this. Notable examples of what Warren Wilson College wants in its students and alumni. To say congratulations is not enough. You are heroes. Sometimes people act as if college is a protected environment, somehow not real life. I always say at commencement that the perception of college as not real life is especially not true here at Warren Wilson, where college is the place where you step out in courage, stand up for what you believe, question almost everything, and are encouraged to be a curious, seeking, growing human. Know that we are with you, walking beside you, as you go into your next chapters, for there is not just one next chapter, but many of them. We and Warren Wilson will always be a part of you, and we are in your corner, rooting for you every step of the way. Others have walked beside you and have been a part of you during your journey at Warren Wilson College. Would you, class of 22, take a minute, think of those who have supported you. Parents, partners, aunts and uncles, grandparents, siblings, friends, and faculty and staff here. And would you, as you think of them, give them a heartfelt round of applause. Thanks to all of you who have supported our students. I wanted to share what some of our students are doing post-commencement. This shows that Warren Wilson graduates are curious, capable, and confident. Going on to further study, UNC Chapel Hill in medicine, UNC Asheville K-6 education, Western Carolina University, social work, the New School, creative writing, anthropology. Already employed, recovery coach at Cooper Reese, teacher, multiple teachers in multiple locations, mural assistant to Laura Nguyen, outreach case manager, A Hope Day Care Center, recreation program coordinator, AmeriCorps, herbarium intern, University of Stillwater, launching leaders program coordinator, Green Mountain Camp, gallery assistant, Woolworth Walk, farmer, Moon Rabbit Farms, river guide and coordinator, Great Northern Resort, forest technician, eco-foresters, data analysts, and those are just the ones that we know about. I know there are so many wonderful places that you are heading off to. For community service, student conservation assistant, prescribed burn crew, Hunger Corps Vista, AmeriCorps, bird banding technician, Wild Bird Research Group. Please know that all of us at the college want to know what you are up to many years into the future. You are about to become our alumni, and I hope you will remain engaged with this special place for years to come. This is my last commencement after a career spanning over 35 years as a high school teacher, college professor, and finally administrator. I have happily dedicated my life to fostering the education of what is now generations of college students. It feels really weird to know that I won't watch graduates walk across a stage from a front row seat or hand out diplomas or be a physical part of this happy moment in the future. But it feels even weirder to realize that my first class of graduates since I earned my PhD and started teaching college students is, and I almost didn't want to say this out loud, wait for it, in their 50s. With college graduates of their own who may have become parents themselves, so I can now say that I am the grandmother of hundreds. What I have learned in my career and in my time here at Warren Wilson, and what I wanted to share with you today, is that learning, changing, and growing never stops. As I step into retirement, I have already planted an ambitious vegetable garden and planned a couple of exciting trips this summer. I've never had enough time to write, although at one time as a college student, I aspired to be a writer. As a college senior, I pictured myself in New York City in a small bohemian apartment with a typewriter. Typewriters, that's a device that is sort of like a computer, only slower, heavier. I would have lots of suitably bohemian friends. It was 1979, y'all. No computers, no cell phones, no social media. It was pretty easy to do things your parents would never find out about. Instead of moving to the Big Apple, I got married young, raised three children, earned a master's and a doctorate simply for the love of literature, and because I wanted to avoid working in a cubicle. I was repeatedly told that a PhD in English literature was a stupid idea, career-wise. A word of advice, don't listen to those people, and you know who they are, the anchor on your dreamboat. And I managed to collect a ridiculous number of books, rather than writing any, which I have lugged around in three different states and multiple dwellings and offices for some reason. As a college president, I was stretched at times beyond anything I've experienced before, and I'll be spending some time reflecting on how I've grown and changed. But perhaps more importantly, I know that my growing and changing is not over, just like yours. Let's go forward with courage and conviction and continue to work for peace, justice, and the common good. Now, I have the pleasure of introducing Lash Zimp, Chair of the Warren Wilson College Board of Trustees. Lash grew up in the Carolinas, but suffered from a bad case of wanderlust. This resulted in a long Greyhound bus ride and 3 days on a ferry to Alaska, where he lived and worked for 20 years. He attended Davidson College and then earned a law degree from the University of New Hampshire Law School of Law. In Alaska, he worked in the summers as a deckhand on commercial fishing boats around the state, and then transitioned to the practice of law in Juneau, Alaska. He returned to the Carolinas 19 years ago, moving to these beautiful southern Appalachian mountains of western North Carolina. He is very well qualified and suited to be the board chair at Warren Wilson College. He recently joined Outward Bound USA as its risk management director. Previously, he was a partner with the Asheville law firm of Roberts and Stevens with 30 years of experience trying cases and representing a variety of professional outdoor recreation, industry and business interests in state and federal courts. He is an active member of the North Carolina Association of Defense Attorneys, having served as past president. Lash is also very involved with the Asheville and Western North Carolina communities, joining our board in 2015. He has previously served on the boards of Southern Appalachian Highlands Conservancy, WCQS Public Radio, Pisgah Legal Services, the Asheville Chamber of Commerce, and Riverlink. Please join me in welcoming Lash Zimp.
Please join me in thanking President Lynn Morton for her 5 years of service. If you're a history major, raise your hand. Sweet. So I was a history major. And the multitudes of history majors out there, I want to offer you hope. To the parents of history majors, I really want to offer you condolences. This is a true story. I shared it this morning. When I graduated from college, I was a history major. And on the morning of graduation, we stood on the corner of the college campus where all the traffic was coming in for commencement. And four of us held up a big sign that said, "We'll think for food." And I would like to congratulate specifically the history majors. President Morton, honored members of the Board of Trustees, esteemed faculty and staff, proud, and can I dare say, relieved parents, family and guests, and most importantly, the college graduates of the Warren Wilson class of 2022. On behalf of the Board of Trustees, I want to congratulate you for what is truly, truly an accomplishment. A few years ago at commencement, I spoke about my dislike for the use of the word awesome. It wasn't the word itself that bothered me, but how, in my opinion, the word had been relegated to the bin of overuse. It was being used in response to any and every experience, even the most mundane experiences. I washed my car today. That's awesome. Then, at that talk, I attempted to resurrect its true meaning by asking that class of graduates to take a moment to think about their time on this campus, this incredible campus, with faculty and staff, this wonderful, supportive faculty and staff, with their work crew and their fellow students, the bonds of friendship for a lifetime, and to embrace how incredibly and truly awesome their time here has been. What I feel today and what I have felt for most past 2 years is different. What I feel today and what I have felt for most of the past 2 years is different. You're doing a great job. Today, what I feel is extreme and deep gratitude. I can talk really loudly. Yeah. As young children, we are taught very early to say thank you upon receiving a small Is it just me? Oh, you. As young children, we were taught very early to say thank you, and upon receiving the smallest token or act of kindness, we were taught to say thank you. On a daily basis, we express thanks, appreciate it, thank you, with gratitude, thanks much. So reflexively and routinely that the feeling of gratitude those words are intended to convey sometimes gets lost. There are infinite memes, self-help slogans and mottos, and any number of books, tapes, podcasts that focus on the importance of feeling and expressing gratitude. Like the overuse of the expression of awesome, expressions of gratitude are so pervasive that they sometimes dull the feeling they are intended to express. Today, here with you on this very special day, there is no meme that adequately conveys the gratitude that I feel. You, the class of 2022, have been through 2+ years of the strangest, weirdest, and toughest times I have experienced in my life. You've had to wear a mask, isolate, quarantine, be socially distant, be disconnected, interact remotely, and be virtual. Your ability to connect, learn, experience, share, and just be were put under enormous strain. You and your parents and those who love and care about you were worried, concerned, and scared about your becoming sick and your overall well-being, and, quote, how long this pandemic and its impact on all of us would continue. You have had a college experience like no others in my lifetime. And here you are today, you are here today, standing here, looking at you with the knowledge of what you have experienced, I certainly feel admiration. But much deeper and truer and real for me, I feel mostly deep and abiding gratitude. So on behalf of the trustees of Warren Wilson College and all of us here in celebration with and of you, I want to say with all my heart, thank you. It is my great pleasure, and if you're not on his social media account, you need to be. The Warren Wilson experience was transformational for many of our graduates, and they stay connected to the college and to our students. To congratulate the class of 2022, I would like to introduce the chair of our alumni board, Pinky Stegall, class of 2007.
I don't think, I've been to a lot of graduations. I don't think I've ever seen the graduation lawn here in front of Sunderland this full. It's beautiful. This is a special graduation. So, hi friends, I'm Pinky Stegall, class of 2007 and alumni board president. It's been a long journey for each of you to get here. And I'd like to give you my deepest congratulations on behalf of all our alumni. It takes a special kind of person to go to Warren Wilson. And though we're all products of a different time, we have the same core values and we're cut from the same cloth. Like the admissions brochures used to say, we're not for everyone, but maybe you're not everyone. This Green Valley is your home. Just like it is for the class of 1962 and 1982 and 2002. It's been our home for 128 years. We've built it together, and throughout your life, this valley will always be here for you to return to. It will evolve with the times, just as it did to become the place you've attended, but it will always be your home. As you go out into the world, you'll stumble across other Wilsonites from time to time, whether you're in your hometown or in a rural village on another continent. We always find each other in the weirdest places. You'll get excited when you see an owl tattoo and leave notes on strangers' windshields when you spot a Wilson sticker in the parking lot. Because you know what that tree means. You know it's someone like you. Freedom fighters and mountain climbers and teachers and healers and givers. People with big hearts and big ideas that care and that make a difference. People that know how to start fires and how to put them out. People that love cows and know what a tardigrade is. People like you, and this valley is our home. I know you're tired of hearing that you're resilient, but yours is a special class. You've made it through something that hasn't happened for 100 years. You have a special place in Warren Wilson history and will have your very own chapter in the archives. The entire alumni base cares about you. We really do. Also, I want to take a moment to honor your former classmates that aren't graduating today, who didn't make it through. They may not be walking across the stage with you, but the same values that brought you to this valley brought them here too. And they're part of our tribe as well. And they know what it means to be a Wilsonite, just like you, and we value them. So I just want to honor them too. But take the things you've learned here, and as you go out into the world, make it a little more like the Swannanoa Valley. Serve others, make it better, bring good news back and bad, and tell us all about it. Congratulations to each of you, and welcome to your alumni family. We're all so, so proud of you.
It's my pleasure to introduce this year's senior speaker, Pratima Minyanko. Pratima was chosen by her peers to speak today. Pratima's chemistry capstone project asked the question, how does ginsengoside composition vary across wild and wild simulated American ginseng populations? In addition to this project, she also completed another independent research presentation with Professor Zhang on the topic of development of low-cost, high-performance electrocatalysts for hydrogen production. As a Bonner leader, Pratima did extensive work in the Shiloh Community Garden and the Dr. Wilson Community Garden, where she helped to maintain the garden and facilitate visitor groups. She also collaborated with another Bonner to run week-long workshops under the topic of the school-to-prison pipeline. Pratima, who completed her degree in December, is already working full-time as an associate scientist in a biopharma company doing work that involves the usage of analytical methods to test different drugs and compounds. Pratima is always an independent, curious, and critical thinker. She asks good questions and is enthusiastic about finding the answers. And as you are about to hear, she is conscientious, dependable, and confident. Please join me in welcoming Pratima Minyanko. Thank you. Thank you, Len, for the introduction. As a senior speaker for this graduating class 2022, I feel immensely honored and responsible to be the voice that represents today's celebrated individuals. Truthfully, I'm speaking from my reflections as a Warren Wilson College graduate, hoping to capture the varied stories of this graduating class. I think an undergraduate degree can be merely viewed as an achievement which is possible after checking off the requirements for a certain program, or it can be spiced up by challenging yourself to get out of your comfort zone, which may look like having an active participation in class for someone like me who doesn't speak a whole lot during class discussions, or maybe picking courseworks that will open up a new perspective for you, examining your biases, or being intentional about building friendships with people from different backgrounds, of different races, religion, age groups, or nationalities. One of the highlights of my time as a Warren Wilson College student has been the theme of friendships. I remember hearing this quote by a motivational speaker once that said, "Don't be a starfish. If you want to make new friends, you have to take initiative and instead of waiting for someone else to pick you up." For a small residential college like ours with a triad program of community engagement, work program, and academics, we are given multiple opportunities to interact with each other on different occasions. This makes it easier for us to find like-minded friends with similar values. At the same time,
It also acts like an icebreaker for strangers who initially might not have had the chance or courage to get to know each other. Both intentionally and unintentionally, I have found myself seeking the companionship of my peers and realizing how friendship has been important in making what I initially thought just an academic journey much more memorable. While some friends lasted all 4 years, some did not, due to various reasons. As they say, change is the only constant. We dived into a change in our lives to receive an undergraduate degree in our field of interest. Throughout this period, we experienced changes every semester, every year. And one of the biggest changes that we experienced was the pandemic that triggered significant changes in our triad program. I think through thick and thin, we have emerged as more flexible, resilient, and curious individuals. We all hold unique stories of our time that started here and that has a formal closure today. Personally, my Morrisville and college stories revolve around having long conversations while on hiking trails on Jones Mountain, Swannanoa River, or while sharing meals in our mostly vegetarian vegan cafe Kalpai. And small classrooms where we build close relationships with our professors and peers. The outdoor leadership trips to the Sword of Mountain, Catawba Falls, and the kayaking trips to the French Broad River only spoke of the adventurous spirits of the Warren Wilson College student. And those were memorable times. We all might not have had the same starting point, but we all shared the same ending point. For some, this is a huge milestone. For some, this may be a stepping stone towards grander dreams. There are a multitude of different extents of effort put into for today to be a reality, depending on your background, coursework, or experiences. However, today, we all share this joyous moment of our lives amidst the differences. Today is a celebration of the closure of our Warren Wilson College chapter as a student. Thank you.
Taking that road, got nowhere to be but places to go. Don't worry about me when I'm out on the road. Worry about me when I don't come home. Thank you. in that whole world. I carry the weight of the ones I love. We stand in love, oh, you know, love's to be shared. Some people didn't care, but we don't do it for them.
Piece of music. And thank you, Jason, DeCristofaro, and Kevin Kehrberg of our music department. It is my pleasure and privilege to welcome our speaker today, Emmy Award-winning journalist and diplomat, Dr. Elizabeth Colton. Dr. Colton grew up in Asheville and went on to live in 13 countries and work in 120 countries throughout her career as an award-winning diplomat in the Peace Corps, UN, and US Foreign Service, as a Fulbright scholar, as an Emmy-winning journalist, reporter, and editor, as a teacher of elementary and secondary schools, and as a professor at the university level. She earned her PhD in social anthropology from the London School of Economics. She currently serves as a professor of diplomacy and media for UNITAR, the United Nations Institute for Training and Research, and Collaborative International University's Global Online Courses. She serves as the board chair of the Global Reporters Sans Frontières, Reporters Without Borders. I don't speak French, y'all, sorry. RSF USA North America, with headquarters in Paris, France. Currently, she is serving as diplomat and journalist in residence here at Warren Wilson College. In that position, she provides her time as a professor, scholar, diplomat, and communications expert to teach, lecture, and mentor students, and to promote Warren Wilson College locally, nationally, and globally. Dr. Colton's connection to Warren Wilson began when she was young. Her parents brought her to Warren Wilson College for international events, and her family would host international students during the holidays and for big meals. She says that Warren Wilson has served as a foundation in her own life. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Elizabeth Colton. Dr. Colton will be speaking from the walkway.
Thank Thank you very much, Dr. Morton. Thank you very much to all of you. And thank you for this accommodation. I think we all know that at some point in our lives, if young or old, we may have some kind of little handicap, and I'm most grateful that I didn't have to be carried up the steps because of an ankle. To commence, to begin. Thank you very much. Congratulations.
Thank you, Dr. Colton. It's a great honor to have you working with us at Warren Wilson, and we so appreciate your words. Everybody go forward with the word glocal. I really love it. I now call on our provost, Dr. J. Roberts, to join me for the presentation of the degrees.
President Morton, I have the honor to present the following candidates for the Bachelor of Arts or Bachelor of Science. They've satisfied all the requirements and have been approved by the faculty. I now ask you, by your official act, to confer upon them their degrees.
By the authority vested by the trustees of Warren Wilson College, I confer upon you the degree of Bachelor of Arts or Bachelor of Science. I admit you to its rights and privileges and remind you of its responsibilities. Congratulations. Will the class of 2022 now come forward to receive your diplomas, following which Associate Dean of Community and Global Engagement, Anna Welton, and Associate Dean of Work, Paul Bobbitt, will present you with a white pine sapling seedling in recognition of your achievements in work and community engagement as a symbol of the experiential learning that is such a special part of our education.
Here we go. Sabrina Alvarado, in absentia. Daniel Acacella. Esther Afrani. Emanuela Afrani. Benjamin Ehring. Tasia Allen. Peyton Annapol. Alex Ardagna. Lauren Ballard, in absentia. Abigail Barnes. Daniel Barron. Kayla Bell. Kizar Berger. Elenaya Black. Woo! Leonardo Gomez Borges. Julie Bowles. Kara Bridgman. Callie Brown. Autumn Bryant. Grace Buffalo. Catrice Cade in absentia. Joy Cantrell. Ruben Cardenas Callejas. Dania Carlton. Reed Carpenter. Christopher Carroll. RJ Chiquito in absentia. Bella Cimino. Braxton Clark. Sam Colston. Autumn Corbin. Kylie Cordell. Sophie Cornejo. Madeline Cox. Sierra Davis. Vigilance Deadman. Rachel Dunaway. Hannah Duncan. John Duncan in absentia. Alec Dunn. Corey Dunn. Gabriel Efron. Jeremy Epstein. Trinity Isola. Jasmine Featherstone. Beatrice Fay. Camille Ference in absentia. Riley Francis in absentia. Joshua Furman in absentia. Thalia Garofalidis. Woo! Dara Goldsmith. Elias Goldstein. Taylor Goldstein. Parker Gondella. Maya Goodman. Hannah Grant. Maisie Greenberg. Vincent Grossi. Hatchet. Shelby Ann Hairston. Journey Ham. Juna Hartzler. William Hayes. Ian Heaps, in absentia. Ainara Hidalgo. Damon Hinkleman. Marissa Hitchco. Kimberly Hodges. Catherine Horman, in absentia. Claire Hofelt. Chandler Cham Holland. Connor Holtz. Mason Hopkins. Samantha Hoyle. Colin Husk. Megan Anantuano. DeMarco Jackson. Jordan Johnson. Atlas Jones. Olivier Capadia. Nicholas Kelly. Gabe Kildgore. Declan King. Timothy Kinsey. Adrian Lacey. Zoe Lam. Colin Lampkin. Harrison Chase Laster. Felicity Lazarus South in absentia. Alden Lee. Krista Manny in absentia. Savannah Martinez. James Meyer in absentia. Ranganayuki Mayshark. Emmeline McManus. Honey McManus. Fatima Menyangbo. Vivian Mills. Naaman Mills. Patrizia Mobile Cepeda. Mallory Monroe. Danica B. Moody. Jonatas Morera Ferreira. Oliver Morgan. Gemma Natanson. Emma Noel. Rachel O'Connor. Jacqueline Owens. Ashley Pacheco Lujano. Lucy Packer. Diksha Palike. Sophia Palmer. Jillian Parker. Elizabeth Patton. Celeste Penley. Astrid Picard. Karina Pittman. Lila Simone Redine. Caleb Resnick. Anastasia Rossano. Becca Robinson. Julian Roan Capilero. Wyatt Roper. Melanie Russell. Eliana Sachs Smith in absentia. Benjamin Schmid. Sarah Scott. Bria Antoniel Scott. Dara Marie Scott. Amy Schaefer. Bassam Shawamre. Emily Rose Shepherd. Sydney Shields. Madison Sings. Sarah Slaymaker. C. Smith. Madison Solario. Cassidy Stoneberg. Noah Swope. Pascal Tessier in absentia. Brian Thompson. Luke Tyner. Alexandra Tikach. Chestnut Van Bramer. Ethan Vanderbleek. Eric Vanderford. Zoe Wallace. Delaney Ward. Catherine Wichard. Abigail Whipple. Woo! Sahara White. Rebecca White, in absentia.
Yeah, Rebecca!
Callie Williams. Kashina Viloche. Ursa Woodring. Evan Timothy Woody. Carlos Wyrick. Graduates, you may now turn your tassels to the left.
Closing the ceremony, I would like to congratulate all the seniors who received awards, especially Madison Sings, who received the POF Cup, our highest student award of the college, and Reed Carpenter, who received the Sullivan Award at last night's honors and awards ceremony at the chapel. I also want to acknowledge and thank the faculty and staff on the commencement committee who have worked so hard to help make this ceremony happen, as well as all the employees who have continued to serve our students with care this year under challenging circumstances. My thanks to all of you, family members, friends, crew supervisors, faculty, staff, and others who helped share and shape the experiences of the class of 2022. We will close with our new version of our alma mater, led by Katie Kalufo of our music department, and a benediction from our college chaplain and director of spiritual life, Dr. Shannon Spencer, and associate director of interfaith initiatives, Reverend Matthew Hoffman. We ask that you please remain at your seats during the recessional until the graduates and faculty and staff members have departed the area. Immediately following, we invite you to the formal gardens and Morris Pavilion for reception. Also, please seek out our professional photographer who will be taking pictures under the portico at Kittredge where you lined up if you would like to have additional photographs made. We look forward to celebrating with you and your families. Thanks everyone so much for being here. I was supposed to say, please stand for the singing of the alma mater.
Thank you for your patience.
while we're grading, friends. Can we give a great big round of applause to our graduates?
From this place, please hear these words.
Take this valley with you, how it shaped, cradled, and inspired you.
May you fondly remember the times that you walked the paths of Dogwood or the River Trail.
May you remember late night conversations and early morning work shifts.
May you recall lessons learned and deep friendships formed.
May you carry a love of learning and community building.
Take this, all of this, and hold it in your heart forever.
And as this place has done for so long, this valley will always be here to cheer you on and pick you up.
So go from this space knowing that you are loved. All of you, just as you are holy, and your story sacred.
So like a thousand stars by night, light the way. Be generous in spirit and love fiercely.
Like a thousand stars by night, burn with a righteous hope of what can be, what will be.
Go from this place and live into the person that you were created to be.
Thank you. Yes, Ellen was also taking photos and videos.
Buck shot us a photo as well. Your mother told me to set up four cameras.
And I can't find Marge or Buck either, so I'm guessing I'll just see them. I can't find any of my people.
Right, step around here. Step around here. Say hello to yourself.
Hi.
Is it backlit? Give me your presentation. Should this go inside there?
Yeah, I think so. And it's just showing the sky right now. It's not showing people.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Well, Pick up my diploma again. They actually don't have it in here. They don't give it to you yet.